Because I'm ready. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my sincere pleasure to announce that it is tea time, and this is really damn hot. I hope you're having a good day. My name is Tuskeh, and welcome, welcome to the stream. If you're watching this on YouTube, I do in fact stream it all. That's right. Well, my plan is to stream it all anyway. I hope it goes well. I have issues with my internet, apparently, and like the stream just doesn't like me, but we'll just go with it anyway. So, tea time. Yes. It's been a long time since we've done one of these, and I've actually got a lot of comments about it, people saying, oh, you know, why, where is tea time? What are you doing? What's going on? Well, in truth, a lot of stuff has happened, and really, it's been difficult. I will say that. It's been a very difficult couple of months, really, and I've struggled a lot with motivation, but I'd like to talk about that. And I'd also like to just get it out there because I've been thinking a lot about whether or not I should talk to you folks about this and what's on my mind. Especially on my mind is this damn cold sore here. Yay for being an adult, apparently. You still get this kind of shit when you're an adult. But anyway, point was that I'm just going to talk to you about what's going on, what's mattering, all of that stuff. Let me just move my microphone a little bit so that it's just out of shot. Look at me, I'm very professional. So, I hope everyone in the chat is having a good day. We had a good old chat pre-stream, and it seems like everything is going well. So, the first thing we have to do is we have to decide what game we're playing, because I'm not just going to sit here on my camera and talk to you, because that would be boring, because I have a boring face. So, the question is, do we do Guild Wars 2? Because I'm in the mood for Guild Wars 2, I'll admit that. I am happily in the mood to play Guild Wars 2, to show you guys what it's about, and just have fun with it, because Guild Wars 2 is a fun game to play. Or we could level the monk, which would be a bit more, I don't know if it'd be forced. I might have to get into it a little bit, but that's definitely something we could do. We could also play Heroes of the Storm, we could play Hearthstone, or I could do WoW PvP, because apparently you guys want to see me do Elemental Shaman PvP, and you want to see me suffer. So that's apparently a thing. But for now, I say we start with Guild Wars 2. So I'll get that loaded up. I will warn you ahead of time that I'm an idiot and I didn't actually correct the sound. I didn't do any sound checks with Guild Wars 2. So if this is suddenly really loud, I apologize. So just prepare yourselves for that. I'm just hitting the login button and then I'll flip it over. I've got all the audio, the visual sorted out, I think. And here comes the loudness. Oh, no, I actually did do it properly. Yeah. Yeah. All right, so let me move this over. So here we are. This webcam placement might not make a lot of sense, but it will make sense once we get into the game. This is also quite loud, so I'm just going to turn this down a little bit. There we go, that's good. So this is Guild Wars 2. Guild Wars 2, if you know nothing about it, it is an MMO that was released in 2012. I believe it was 2012. And it really shook up the way you do a lot of MMOs, especially the combat. This game rewards you for doing pretty much anything. Like, it rewards you for literally wandering around in circles and finding shit. You can just get chests of loot by doing that. It's really cool. It also rewards you and gives you loot just by logging in every day, which is, again, pretty cool. Right now, this game is completely free. I'm not being paid or anything like that. But, yeah, this game is completely free right now. And that, I could not recommend it more, because this game is fantastic. So, While we do this, I'll just quickly take you through my characters. So I have a level 80 necromancer. All of my characters are char, by the way. There are five races? Yeah, I think so. You've got humans, which are humans and boring. Norn, which are like big humans and equally boring. Silvari, which are like elfy bark tree people humans. Asura, which are gnomes with long ears. And char, which are basically giant cat people, which is these guys. They are awesome, so all of my characters are char. So we have my level 80 necromancer here that I've done nothing with for a while. I've got a level 11 char ranger. The maximum level in this game, by the way, is level 80, up until the Heart of Thorns expansion comes along. So, and then I have a ranger here. I have a elementalist here, which is like a shaman, but better, because their spells actually have some punch to them. I've got a level 21 char engineer, which I've been enjoying a lot. The engineer's really cool, because it's kind of very out there. It's like, oh, so what do you do to deal damage? Oh, I throw grenades, and then I use a flamethrower. And then to heal people, I literally just get a big gun that fires elixirs. That's pretty cool. And then I have a guardian. A guardian's kind of like a paladin, except you can... it is essentially like a paladin. there are some distinct differences, but I don't know it well enough to just say it's different in these ways. But every class in Guild Wars 2 can heal, and every class in Guild Wars 2 can perform every role. And it's important to note that because there aren't really any kind of roles in Guild Wars 2. There's not like a tank, a healer, and a DPS. Some classes do better at some things than others. Like the Guardian, for instance, is very good at removing dots and removing debuffs and buffing their allies, but they don't have any, like, this is a healing tide totem, you know? There's not like a, oh, here's lay on hands, here's a big heal. You only have one heal ability that you can use at any one time, and every class has that. So it's everyone's responsibility to look after themselves. So yes, just saying hi to the chat. Let's just say Immortality says, hey Tuskeh, how you doing? I'm doing good. KSA Oz says, hi Tuskeh. Hello, I hope everything's going well. Everything's good here. So what we're going to do is we'll go on to the Guardian, I think, for now. And we'll get talking about the things what are important to me. Because I figure not telling you guys that this stuff is difficult. And the main problem I have right now is that basically the stuff that's been going on the last couple of months is really depressing. And I don't want to be sitting here like, oh, this thing happened, and then this thing happened, and then this thing happened, and oh, it's all so terrible. Because some of that did happen, but there's a good ending to it, at least, which is fantastic. I'll just hit the play button, and we'll get going. Final Wolfpack wants to know what he should get on his pizza. I'm very boring with my pizza, I'm afraid. I just have the normal... I just have, like, cheese and pepperoni, and that's it. I'm really boring. So anyway, yes, this is Guild Wars 2. It's a very, very pretty game. And I'm currently in what's called the Black Citadel, which is the home city of the Char. They're a very technological race. And here is my dude right here. He's a Guardian, so he has a lot of abilities. Here's something you can do in Guild Wars 2 that you can't do in WoW. You can use all of your abilities without a target. It's very action-based. So if I had one target in front of me and I hit them with my mace, it would deal damage. But if I had three targets in front of me and I hit them with my mace, with my auto-attack, it would hit all three of them. So you have all these abilities that you can use. Like, this puts a little area on the ground. I can shield myself and then explode, which is pretty cool. It'll, like, do that. And I can set myself on fire, and then throw fire, and then I can breathe fire. It looks pretty cool. And what's also interesting about this game is that your skills are dependent upon what weapon you're using. So that was all my abilities right now. But if I press this button and swap to my second weapon set, which is a hammer, I have all of my abilities now suddenly different. This attacks really slowly, but you have all these different abilities. This one makes me jump forward. This one fires out these spectral chains that root enemies so I can go up to them. I have this ability that launches enemies around, and then I can make this circle around me that enemies can't cross the circle, so I can lock them in or lock them out. So all kinds of stuff like that. So if I go to the equipment tab here, I've got all these different things. I could equip a greatsword, and then suddenly I've got all these other different abilities. I can do this whirlwind ability. I can leap. I can put stuff on the ground. I can do more whirling stuff. It's all kind of very action-based. But well, that's the basics so far. You also have these kind of slot skills on the right-hand side of your action bar. On the left-hand side of your action bar is your weapon skills. On the right is your slot skills. You can choose them here. You gain points as you level up and you do stuff in the world, and they let you unlock more abilities. So right now I'm using Retreat, which provides swiftness and blocks one attack to nearby allies. Very useful for getting around in the world to just kind of move faster. There's no mounts in this game, so swiftness is important. I've got Signet of Wrath, which increases the damage I deal with dots, aka fire, setting people on fire. And then if I activate it, I can immobilize my target. I've got this this other ability here, which is converts all the debuffs I've got into buffs. So if I'm crippled, so I'm moving slowly, if I've got poison on me, if I'm bleeding, I press this button and suddenly I gain swiftness and regeneration and protection. So it's like the, aha, I'm immune to all your conditions kind of stuff. This is a very kind of PvE build. PvP is very different in this game. But yeah, generally that's what I'm using so far. And then number 6 is your heal ability. So this cures a condition every few seconds on myself. And then if I activate it, I just heal myself. Bam! I'm at full health, so it does nothing. But it has about a 40-second cooldown. And you've got different ways that you can heal yourself here. So this one blocks attacks while I heal. Makes me immune while I'm healing. This one makes me heal myself and allies in a cone in front of me. And this one also lets me heal myself, and then I heal myself more depending upon how much I kill enemies. So there's a lot of diversity in how you build your character. There are some cookie cutter builds, but you can generally do what you want and you'll do okay. So that's pretty cool. So yes, let's talk about what's important. How hot is this tea? It's fairly hot, so we'll see that for a while. So yes, let me tell you a quick story as we wander around the Black Citadel. I'll just quickly explain what I'm going to do. So this is the Black Citadel. This is the map. As you can see, there's a lot to do here. All of these little icons are like undiscovered points of interest. There are waypoints. You can teleport to any waypoint from anywhere in the world for a little bit of copper, which is really good. I can literally teleport from here to like the other side of the world over to here, to this human city. I could just go to this waypoint right now and it would cost me 77 copper and I can just shoop, go all the way. So that's pretty cool. But what each map has is it has a completion bar, you see here. And by discovering all the waypoints, the points of interest, and the vistas are just like a camera, like, angle, just shows you cool stuff, you get a reward. So I'm just going to wander around and do that while I talk. So something kind of sucky has happened. If you're following me on Twitter or Facebook or any of that kind of stuff, then you will probably know that a few weeks ago, it feels like much longer, but probably about a month ago, my father-in-law had an episode. He collapsed in front of his computer. Me and my husband weren't actually in the house at the time, but an ambulance was called and he was rushed to hospital. And he was in hospital for a while, and of course it interrupted all our plans. I was actually out on I was at a birthday party actually with my husband at the time, and he got a call from his mum basically saying something's happened to your father and it's bad, and he's in the hospital. You need to come. So we did that. We had to abandon our friends, which sucked, but they understood because they're our friends. And so we went there. We went to the hospital, and it was really surreal because we went to the hospital, and there he was. He was just there, you know. And oh, I fell and took damage. Whoops. This is the crafting station. You can do a lot of profession stuff here, but I won't go into that right now. But yeah, so he went to we went to the hospital, and the room was really weird. Like if you've ever seen a show like House, I watch a lot of House. It's a kind of a hospital drama show. I watch it on Netflix. Highly recommended. So you see here, I just discovered a point of interest, and you see, just discovering it gave me some experience, which is really cool. So yeah, if you've ever seen anything like House, you know those scenes where you've got like the room and like all the like the drips and like stuff injected into people's arms with pipes and stuff like that. That's what it was like. It was really surreal and very scary. He was very weak. We didn't know what was going on, and we had to wait for like 6 hours just in a room with him, watching him, you know, like half asleep, just the entire family. And it was difficult, and I definitely felt like an outsider there, I have to say, because Well, I mean, the whole family's there, and I'm this outsider from England, and it's all very, it was very surreal, and I felt like an outsider, but they made me feel at home after a while, which was good. And after a while, he was admitted into the hospital, and all this kind of tests happened. A couple days passed. In fact, it might have just been one day. So we go home, and we barely get any sleep. We come back to the hospital the next day. We spend the whole day with him, and they've been doing tests on him all this time, and his doctor comes in and basically says to him, we found a cancerous tumor in your kidney, and we believe it may have also spread to your small intestine, which means that we can't operate, which basically sucked, as you can imagine, because that's basically him saying, yeah, you're probably going to die soon, which shook up the whole family. And as you can imagine, video making at this point, tiny priority compared to all this stuff that's happening. And so that happened, and we were just kind of sitting around just waiting, and the guy basically just said that the doctor, he was a very good doctor, he just said, we're going to transfer you to a cancer center in the nearby city, Pittsburgh, because I do live in Pennsylvania, and they'll do more tests on you, and they'll figure out basically what this cancer exactly is. They'll do they'll get a biopsy of it, or just get a sample, but that's surgery, to figure it out exactly what it is and how far it's spread and all that stuff. So just as a side note, this is a vista. So it's like a little jumping puzzle to find a place, and you press this and you get this cool view. The camera kind of pans out and you get this really nice view of the game. This is an interesting juxtaposition of what I'm talking about. It's like, oh, here's a cool camera angle. Here's a nice camera angle. Also cancer. Don't worry, this cancer story has a good ending. So yeah, that's the Black Citadel. Looks pretty cool, doesn't it? So yes, Lustrom asks what I'm playing. I'm actually playing Guild Wars 2 right now. I'm showing people Guild Wars 2 because I'm enjoying this. And I'm also talking about what's happened recently. So I'll actually put that up there and playing. So Guild Wars 2 is what I'm playing right now. So, yes. So he gets transferred to the cancer center and they do some tests. And out of nowhere, we get news after a couple of days. Also, what is this hairstyle? Oh my goodness me. We get news after a couple of days that the cancer has actually not spread to his small intestine. And they may just be able to remove his kidney, because you can live on one kidney. And if they remove his kidney, and he could just be cancer-free at that point. And that would be amazing. So we were hoping for that. And that turns out what the case was. They figured out they could do that. And then they did surgery on him. And he came out of it just fine. And we basically visited him every day when he wasn't having tests or any of the kind of surgery or anything like that. And it was a stressful time, to say the least. And, I'm just trying to formulate exactly what I feel about it, because obviously I was immensely worried about everyone, because I was worried about my husband and how he was handling it, because he'd shut me out, basically. That's his kind of instinctive response, is to just be quiet all the time. So I was very worried about him, and I was worried about everyone, and basically everything stood still for a while. Like, all my friends and family offered all their support, but basically I just didn't do anything for a while. And the problem with that, and I'm not saying it was a bad idea, it was a good idea to focus on my family, absolutely, I'd do it again, but the problem with that is that this is a big gladiatorial arena, isn't that cool? The problem with not focusing on videos for a while means that you lose a lot of momentum, and momentum is really important in YouTube. So if you like make videos, you make videos, and then suddenly you stop, it's really difficult to get back into making videos in a coherent schedule again, which is part of the reason why I just kind of didn't make videos for a while. Not only that because of all this cancer stuff, but because of the momentum problem. So here's me teleporting to a waypoint. I just teleported back up there because there was nothing down here. But yeah, so that really sucked. And someone asks, are you gay? Yes, I am. It's not a big deal. I have Tito. That's a bigger deal right now. Oh, lovely. So where am I going? Let's head south, into the core. So yeah, it is obviously awful and traumatizing and terrifying, but it had a happy ending. And it's really made me think a lot about what I do for a living. And I mean, I know that we as gamers in general, we tend to take games really seriously, and that's cool. Right? I think it's really cool that we take video games as seriously as we do, you know, that we're so passionate about it. It can get a bit far sometimes. There's actually an instance in here that you can enter that has a point of interest in it, which is pretty cool. It's like a prison area. And the personal story, you get a personal story. It actually, like, takes place in areas like this, but this place is just using it for this point of interest here. But yeah, so it's really terrifying, and despite the fact that we take games so seriously, in the grand scheme of things, they're not important. It's that simple. But then you could say the same thing about anything. I mean, I could go out and I could become a doctor or an astrophysicist, or I could work on I could work with charities and all that stuff. But at the end of the day, when the universe ends, it won't matter. That's a ridiculous statement to say. But it makes me realize that I'm glad to focus on video games, because they're so important to me. And, I mean, they're so important to so many people. And you can really combine, I think, you can combine this love for video games with some really thoughtful processes and some really interesting discussions. And that's kind of what I try to do. Someone asks what this chest above the map is. This is actually a reward chest. So what this is you get rewards for logging in on consecutive days. Actually, I said that wrong. You don't have to log in like every day to get consecutive rewards. Just like every time you log in, you advance up this track. So you start with something simple. You get like mystic coins. Those help with crafting. Then you get laurels. They're kind of like an account-wide gear currency. Then you get luck. You can use luck to increase your gold find. Kind of like Diablo 3. You increase your chances of getting better loot. You get a chest of goods. And then you just like get a bag of crafting materials. And it keeps going and it keeps going and it keeps going. Until finally you get to this chest of loyalty. Which contains a permanent 2% increase to the account gold find. Across your entire account. And you get a choice of an ascended crafting material. Which is basically like some of the best legendary crafting material in the game. Laurels. Which are, again, that currency. Or Tomes of Knowledge. Now, Tomes of Knowledge, you just use them and you instantly level up. Which is really cool. So today I get 6 mystic coins, and then these are available daily quests that I can do. So like if I go to the Maguma jungle and mine ore, I get a reward chest. If I go and complete a fractal, which is kind of like an instance, I get a reward. If I go to a zone called Frostgorge Sound and complete some events there, I get rewards. And if I complete a boss called the Shadow Behemoth today, I get rewards. So it's loads of stuff like that. So here's my account, here's my inventory, and here are my mystic coins. And what's really cool is you can deposit crafting materials directly into a bank, just like that. You like they won't clog up your inventory. It's really nice. Here's some luck. You get it by doing stuff, all kinds of stuff. You get rewards for doing everything in this game. So that's pretty cool. Someone asks, Bubble Boy asks, so how are the servers in Guild Wars 2? I believe they're EU and USA separated, and you pay money to get in. How did I get into Guild Wars 2? I actually just found out about it when it released and played it then. This is something, it's actually a free game, there's no subscription free, and right now you can play it for free. How it makes money is this Black Lion Trading Company store. You can buy all kinds of stuff here. So, if I just go to different, let's go to style. You could buy all kinds of different looks. You can't buy gear, right? You can't buy gear at all. You can buy boosters to like XP, crafting, speed, things like that. But all of this stuff, these are just skins. They don't affect you in any way. So you've got all these kinds of looks here. Loads of them. They've really been pushing this stuff. And 800 gems is like $8, something like that, maybe $10. So you can do all of this stuff. You see there's loads and loads of stuff. You can wear some truly ridiculous things. You can have some cool sunglasses. You can have glowing eyes. You can have hats. You can have massive masks. It looks ridiculous, but you can do all that kind of stuff. You can buy special crafting, gathering materials, because to actually gather materials in the world, you need like an axe, a mining pick, or a scythe. And those run out eventually. These ones, if you buy them, they last forever. And they do different cool things when you use them. Like, they just have cool effects. So you can't buy power, but you can buy convenience. So that's pretty cool. So, yes, let's get back to the story, shall we? After more tea, because more tea is important. I hope you're having tea, and I hope it's good. So, yes, this whole stuff that happened with the cancer stuff has really kind of screwed up my momentum with YouTube, and it's really affected my motivation. Which sucks, because I don't want to be unmotivated. I want to, obviously, make videos for you guys. That's why the Elemental Shaman Guide for 6.2 took so long, because I got intervened by all this stuff, and I only just recently, in the grand scheme of things, released it. So, yeah, that kind of sucks. But, obviously, this has all been terrifying, and I don't really know what else to say about it. It's so strange and so difficult to put into words what it feels like to be told that someone in your life is going to die. And, of course, everyone's going to eventually. That's just the nature of it. This guy actually, Smoder the Unflinching, he's the leader of the Char, so to speak. He's pretty cool. Isn't he cool? Yeah. But yeah. So, I really, I'm struggling to kind of discuss how I feel about it, but it's so strange. Because suddenly, your entire life is just thrown upside down, and it's scary. And I would like to apologize for the amount of videos I've made recently, which is not a lot. And I'd also like to apologize for taking so long to get this out here, because I've been like dwelling on it so much. It's like I've been really stressed out recently. I've actually got pains in my back, and I get headaches quite often just because I've been so stressed out, you know. And raiding in WoW has been a real respite for me, you know, raiding with Legacy Reborn, the guild I'm in. And it's just so stressful. Let's answer more Guild Wars 2 questions. Would you do Enhancement Shaman 6.2 guide? I'm still thinking about guides. I'm working on a Restoration Shaman guide, but that's going slowly. I'm thinking about just doing more general guides, because the guides that I make take so long to create, which is obviously a problem. I'm sure I could do it faster, but I don't know. I need to give that some real thought. I still haven't decided yet. Bubble Boy asks, are there factions? No. Guild Wars 2 does not have a faction system. I can teleport to the human main city, and they're all friendly. There's no faction system, but PvP does exist. There's no world PvP. You have to go to a separate area. There are two places you can PvP. You can do battlegrounds, kind of like WoW. And there's a massive open world area called, like, the Mists. It's like an alternate world where realities clash. And it's a massive world v world ongoing battle event. So there is PvP, and there are it's server versus server rather than like char versus human versus Norn versus Silvari. And I'm playing a massive humanoid tiger, Super Captain, because massive humanoid tigers are awesome. They can also breathe fire, which is really cool. But yeah, so all this stuff with the cancer has made it difficult to work. And I realize I'm kind of going around in circles here because I'm trying to figure out exactly how to say what I'm trying to say. And I don't know, it's really difficult to do things when you're just sitting there like, well, holy shit, what does it matter? My father-in-law's dying. But as it stands now, he's actually recovering, he's upstairs, he's doing well, everything's cool. So here's another cool thing about Guild Wars 2. Is cultural armor. Now, this is something I'm sure people have wanted in WoW for a long time. Is there's armor in this game that only different races can buy. So here's the cultural armor smith for Char. So let's preview the light armor set. So you just right click and hit preview a few times. So here is the light armor set. This is light? Yeah. No, this is the medium armor set. Yeah, this is the medium armor set tier 1. So this requires level 35. Then you've got, here's the light armor set here. This one is, I really like this one. I think it's really cool. But this armor is designed for the race. And no other race can even preview them. And then here is the heavy armor. This is what I would be using. Bam, ba-dam, 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 ba-dam. Looks pretty cool, doesn't it? Lots of heavy armor. You see, it's completely designed for that race in question. However, there is something a little bit, I wouldn't say annoying. It's more a disappointment that, you can't, like, go backwards in terms of what kinds of gear you can use. Like, as a guardian, I wear heavy armor. I can't wear leather or cloth, which is a bit of a shame. There's no such thing as mail armor. There's just light, medium, and heavy armor. So here's tier 2. They get progressively cooler. So let's have a look at the tier 2 stuff. And yes, Rhino mode activated indeed. So here's the tier 2 heavy armor stuff. Looks pretty cool. I'm not a huge fan of it, but I think it looks cool. What I'm a real fan of, this requires level 40? No, level 60. Yeah, and I'm a real fan of the tier 3 heavy armor set. This stuff costs a lot of gold and requires maximum level. But damn, I think it looks awesome. Look at that. So yeah, pretty damn cool. So yeah. That's it. And someone actually asks, Bubble Boy asks, what are the different classes? They're called professions in this game. And they are, I'll just go through them. I think I'll delete a character because like I don't play this ranger anymore. So we'll just delete him. Delete! Okay, so let's go through making a character. So here are the different races. You've got Char, which are basically merciless warriors. You've got humans, which are humans. They're religious and boring. But you've got the Norn. They're great big people, believe in the spirits of the wild. Kind of like Nords from Skyrim. You've got the Asura. They're very gnome-like, technological, stuff like that. And then you've got Silvari. They are very... they're very nature-loving. They're like, they are made from trees, basically. So if we make a Char here, you can make a male or a female. We'll go with male. And every class can be every race can be every class. So the different classes you have are warriors, which is, this is the cultural armor set, just in gold. You can dye your armor as well, and you can fully transmog your armor. It's got a really great transmog system, very Diablo-like. It's very good. So yeah, so this is the warrior. They're very mobile. They hit hard. They're all about jumping into melee, although they do have access to a rifle and a longbow for doing a bit more kind of damage from range. You've got the guardian, very paladin-like, as I said, all about using things to protect themselves and their allies. You've got Revenant, which is, I don't know anything about Revenant. It's being, you have to have Heart of Thorns, and it has to, it's the expansion class, basically. It's not out yet. But they basically have different stances that use different spirits. Ranger is like a classic hunter, except you can also be melee. You have a few, it's kind of like a mixture of a druid and a hunter from WoW. So you have a lot of different ways of, like, you can, like, summon, like, healing fountains from the earth. You can call swarms of birds. You have a pet, obviously. You can use short bows, long bows, great swords, and then, like, swords and torches and stuff like that. You've got a thief, classic rogue stuff, double daggers, sword, stuff like that, just kind of very mobile, lots of damage. They have a unique system that lets them use all of their abilities at once, or kind of stagger them out. Their abilities don't have cooldowns, instead they use kind of like combo points. kind of like that. It's an energy system. You've got engineer, which is all about using different kits. So you can't weapon swap as an engineer, but instead you can have your rifle out, then you swap to a flamethrower, you use those abilities. You swap to a grenade kit, you throw those out. You swap to a bomb kit, you drop bombs. You swap to an elixir kit, you can heal your allies and debilitate enemies, things like that. So that's the engineer, very versatile. Necromancer is kind of warlock-like, summons undead minions, really damn good at dotting people and turning buffs into debuffs. They also have a unique form of blood magic where they actually put dots on themselves to put stronger dots on their enemies. And there's an ability that you have that transfers dots from you to enemies. So you dot yourself, dot the enemy, and then throw your dots on them, and they're just like, ah, I have 100 dots, and then they die. Elementalist is another very versatile class. They have a unique system that lets them swap between elements. So if they have a staff and they're using fire, they fire fireballs out and like rain stuff from the sky. Then you go to water and suddenly you can heal your allies a little bit and support and like knock enemies down. Then you swap to earth and you knock enemies around. You make walls that they can't pass through. Then you swap to, what's the other one? Air, duh. And you like stun your enemies and you throw them around. It's really cool. And then Mesmer, this is a very unique class. It's very pink. They're also really annoying. I've never played one, but I don't like them. They summon copies of themselves, right? To fight their enemies. And so they'll go up against an enemy and then they'll summon three copies of themselves and they'll all hit them and then you shatter your copies to make them explode and stuff like that. They're really difficult to kill and really mobile and I just don't like them. So someone wanted to see the Silvari, the wood elf-like race. So I'll just read this out for you. Silvari are not born. They awaken beneath the pale tree with knowledge gleaned in their pre-life dream. These noble beings travel seeking adventure and pursuing quests. They struggle to balance curiosity with duty, eagerness with chivalry, and warfare with honor. Magic and mystery entwine to shape the future of this race that has so recently appeared. So this is the Silvari. They're very, they're pretty cool. If I had to play another race, it'd probably be Silvari. But I'm not a huge fan of them myself. I prefer the Char. I mean, this looks cool. And then if you keep going, there's an awful lot of customization you can do. You can customize your height, your body build, all kinds of stuff like that. You can change your skin color, all kinds of stuff like that. All kinds of different faces, hairstyles. I'm quickly showing you this because I don't want to go into too much detail. You can, of course, there's the obligatory sliders section that let you do all kinds of stuff like this to customize your character, make it very unique. It's a good system. It's a very good system. I'm making a weird Silvari here. Very weird Silvari. And then you can, of course, dye your armor as well. You can do this at just about any time in the game, except when you're in combat. But yeah, and then you can unlock dyes and stuff like that. And it's a very robust system. So that's pretty cool. But yeah, that's enough of character creation, I think. I'd like to just play the game for a little bit, actually. So we'll go back onto our Guardian. And if you disagree with my choice of race, then you're wrong. Char are the best. Oh, this tea is so good. This is the best cup of tea I made in ages. So yes, so I talked a bit about the cancer stuff. But we have to snuff them out once and for all. Jeez, they're talking over me. But what I'd really like to talk about is this is going to be a difficult topic. Because this is something if you've watched my first tea time video where I talk about who I am, you probably know quite a bit about me, but there is one aspect of my life that I didn't mention there. Just dude falling from the ceiling. There's one aspect of my life I didn't mention because I still struggle with it, and it's probably the biggest problem in my life, and I'm hesitant to talk about it, but at the same time, I think I want to. And it's a difficult topic. Also, Final Wolf Pack asks, Char or Troll? Troll? Of course. I only play this game on the side. I love WoW. I still love WoW. And if you think I'm wrong, then go and watch my video about why you shouldn't only play one MMO. It's a terrible idea. So, yeah. This particular topic is very difficult for me. And I would like to talk about it. So, all this stuff that's happened with my father-in-law has got me thinking about my own dad. And I have a difficult relationship with my father. Let's put it like that. Yeah. It's difficult because, obviously, I've started thinking about my dad a lot because of all this stuff with my father-in-law. And I don't want to get all down in the dumps about this, so I'll try and remain positive. Let me tell you a bit about this guy. So he's not a very nice person. My mum and my dad are separated. They've been separated since I was 10 years old. That, of course, screwed me about a bit during school. And here's another nice vista to cheer us up. This is like a big smelting yard. Look at all that lava down there. Isn't that cool? I have done this all before, so I know where I'm going, mostly. But yeah, they split up when I was 10, and I've had a strained relationship with him since then. And it's been difficult, mostly because I haven't had much contact with him. I haven't talked to him for, like, 2-odd years now. Not that I don't love him, because of course I do. He's my dad. But he's disappointed me a lot. Like, the times where he'd be like, "I'll come pick you up and we'll go do this thing," when I was a teenager, he would just not show up. Which is, of course, disappointing. He wasn't ever really there for me, and, like, generally, he's not a very nice person. I don't want to go into too much detail because I don't want to insult the guy, right? Because he's my dad, and I love him. And nothing he does will change that, because I'm a nice person, and apparently that's a terrible thing to be. But, yeah. So, all of that. And I've been thinking about him a lot recently because I'm kind of terrified that I'm going to turn into him. Which might sound ridiculous because, I mean, I'm not stupid and I don't want to sound like I'm blowing my own trumpet here, but I know that I'm a nice person, right? I know that. And I'm very different from him in a lot of ways. But, like, he's the kind of person that gets angry quite easily. And recently I found myself, probably thanks to all this stress, getting a bit easy to, like, snap. I've shouted at my computer a lot recently, basically, and I've just been a little bit irritable, and I'm trying to work past that, but I often worry that I'm just turning into my dad because of it. Dodo Brain asks, what does my father do? And this is the painful bit. Nothing. He's on the dole. He doesn't work. He hasn't worked for a long time, and he's never really had a job, which sucks. He relied on my mum, basically, for financial income. And he never really paid child support either after they separated. And he's basically broke, which obviously sucks a lot. And I wish I could give him money, but basically I don't have any to give. But yeah, he's an embarrassment. I'll say that he is. He's an embarrassment. And yeah, it sucks because This is the problem, right? My dad, and I'm going to say this, he is really fucking smart, right? Like, when I was younger, he's the reason I love science. And we would used to go out to McDonald's together, and we would sit and have our meal, and he would just tell me about science. He would talk to me about this book he's been reading, about the universe, and about how big everything is, and how amazing it all is. And he really kindled my love for science in that regard, which is fantastic. And I thank him for that. But the real shame is that he's got this whip-smart mind. He's a smart person. But he's kind of wasted it, to be honest. He really has. He doesn't really do anything with it. Like I said, he doesn't work. He doesn't really do anything with it. I have a phone call, which I'll be ignoring, because no one ever phones me. They email me. So yeah, I apologize for that ringing sound. Nothing I can do about it. I'm short of destroying the phone, which I wanted to do sometimes, I have to admit, when it just rings non-stop for 3 hours. But, yeah. So that's all kind of sucked. And, yes, Dodo Brain is correct when you say, isn't it strange how we still love those that hurt us? Yeah, I've been angry at him before, I've shouted at him before, I've just all that kind of stuff before. This little jumping puzzle there, you see, I had to go across those beams. I'm quite good at the jumping puzzles in this game. But, yeah, I still do love him, and I've forgiven him and all that stuff. But it does really suck that all this stuff happened, and it frustrates me very often because I find myself thinking about him a lot, and it's very difficult to just say, oh, I forgive him, and that's the end of it, you know? Because obviously he did hurt me, and I should also say this is where it gets even worse. Like, I don't want to bum you guys out, I really don't. If I am, let me know, and we can talk about... Actually, I had a good idea. Once we're done with this topic, I'm going to tell you something ridiculously cool and exciting. The thing that I'm, like, super stoked for. Hopefully this doesn't kill me. Nope, it doesn't. Okay, good. But yeah. So, let me know if I am bumming you guys out. But here's the worst part. He smokes a lot and he drinks a lot. To the point where sometimes I've called him up to be like, hey, how you doing? And he's just been drunk. And he's just like, who are you? Which sucks, obviously. That's part of the reason why, you know, I often say, you know, I don't drink. He's the reason why. I mean, maybe in the far future, once I'm over this, I might drink socially. I don't know. But I have bad experiences with that. It's that simple. I mean, you hear tales like this. I've lived them. And it sucks. It really does. It's horrible. But, like I said, I still love him. I do. And, I often worry that I'm going to turn into him. And I've been thinking a lot about what's going to happen. Because he's the only person in my family that smokes a lot. He's the only person in my family that drinks a lot. And Lestrom, you don't count that I'm bumming you out. Because I always bum you out. But at Final Wolfpack Gaming asks, do you have any tattoos? No, I don't have tattoos. I don't have any tattoos at all. I probably wouldn't ever either. It's just not a thing I'm interested in. Not a thing I'm interested in. Talking is hard. But yes. To continue bumming you guys out. Like I said, he's the only person in my family that smokes and drinks. And that basically means he is destined to be the first person that's going to... And I hate saying this. He's going to... Probably going to be the first person that's going to die. Which is a horrible thing to think about. But... It's amazing how well I know this, by the way. I've done this so many times in Guild Wars 2. I've played this game for a long time. That I just kind of know how to get to this thing. But yeah. I've been struggling with that for a while. And thank you for trying to cheer me up by saying you should get a tattoo on your face that looks like a tusk. Just, ah. My god. Nah, that's terrible. Did you know that troll tusks actually come out of the top of their mouths? Not the bottom? They kind of go like that. I can't believe I just did that. Anyway, yeah. So... I've been thinking about that a lot, and all this stuff has been on my mind, right? So I've been thinking about all this stuff that's happened with my father-in-law. I've been worrying, like, about my dad for no reason. And it's really affected the momentum of the videos that I make. And for that, I apologize. I've just been kind of trying to work past it and just go back to what it was like before when I didn't really worry about this stuff. Because this whole scare that we had... with my father-in-law, it really opened my eyes as to all the stuff that's happening around me. Because before then, my biggest problem was something like, oh, I didn't get a video out today. That was terrible. Or, oh, I lost this Heroes of the Storm game. But now, obviously, I've got all this stuff floating around in my head, and I'm trying to sort through it all. And it's taking ages. It's taking everyone in the family ages to sort through this. I'm nearly done with this place. I need 6 points of interest. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the Heroes Canton. I'll have to do my hero story to get in there. And there's one more that I've missed. Somewhere here. Oh, it's just right here. Okay, we'll just teleport over there and get it. and that's what screenshot is for. Yeah, wonderful. But, yeah, it's very difficult to go through all this stuff. You see, there's lots of players here. It's pretty cool. Like I said, I don't want to insult my dad, and I don't want to do all that stuff and complain about him, because there's no point, right? There is literally no point in complaining about him, and I love him, and I want to support him and make him happy, but right now it's just kind of affected me a bit, and sometimes I get angry. I get so angry at him. You know, he's never actually met my husband. It's just never happened. It's going to happen eventually. I just hope that goes well. And actually, I'll tell you this. This is probably going to be the most personal thing I have ever told the public, so to speak. Also, Mint Pony says, hi, Tuskeh. Yeah, hi. you've come in at a very depressing time, I'm afraid. But I have awesome news after this little depressing story is over. So, when I was, 16 years old, maybe a little bit younger, I realized that I was gay. I told my mum, and she basically just said, yeah, I know, it's not a big deal, right? She's my mum. She's amazing. She counterbalances all this by being amazing, and she just knew. And so I told my dad. I remember it really well. Ironically enough, I told him in the pub, because that's where I went to see him, of course. But I remember I told him that I was gay, and the first thing he said to me is he said, you realize this means the family name ends with you. This is the first thing he said to me. And that stuck with me and will probably stick with me for the rest of my life. And that's kind of, in a nutshell, what he is and why I'm so disappointed in him and why I'm terrified of becoming him. Which I suppose that terror of becoming him will by itself keep me away from being him, which is good. But I am so conflicted about it. I honestly don't know what to do because, like, I want to be angry at him, but anger is a terrible, terrible thing to do. There's no point in me being angry at him. It's unhealthy. But at the same time, just saying, hey, I forgive you, is at the same time really difficult. So this has been on my mind for a while now. I've been stressed out because of it. I've been freaking out a bit because of it. And yeah, it's kind of got in the way of making videos. So I apologize profusely for that. But hopefully we can move past that. I just want to say my plans for Legion right now. Bloody hell, Mackers. That must suck. Like, he says, when I came out, I was told I was going to hell, so it could be worse. Oh, good lord. I am so sorry. It sucks, right? It sucks when the response isn't positive, but it needs to be done nonetheless. So, let's just move on from that. And I want to quickly talk about the future. So, like, I'm going to continue to play World of Warcraft and Legion. I hope to get into the beta soon and make loads of videos for that. Just all kinds of videos. I'm going to be super, super, super careful with spoilers. And I'm going to say, like, warning, this video contains major spoilers or minor spoilers or some spoilers. And I'll have, I'm about to mention a spoiler. You have 5 seconds to run away screaming. Things like that. I don't want to spoil it for anyone because spoilers suck. So I'll be making loads of those videos if I can. I'm also interested in getting into the Overwatch beta because that game looks like fun. So I think I'm okay at first-person shooters, so I'll give that a shot. But here's the interesting part. I have news, and this is the exciting bit that we talked about from moving past the whole discussion about my dad. And like, I know I didn't seem like I got anywhere with that, but it was really good to just get that out there and talk about him and just mention that I'm still working through it. Because I have no idea what to do about it. But you people are amazing, by the way. You're all so kind and so amazing. And I just need to alt-tab quickly. And do that. Okay, there we go. So yes, it's fun time now. So I have news. I recently, and by recently I mean earlier today, was able to secure myself 2 tickets to BlizzCon. That's right. Me and my husband are going to BlizzCon. And it's going to be amazing. I'm so excited for it. This weekend we're gonna book the hotel and the flight and everything, because we'll have to fly across America to get there. But BlizzCon! I've never been to BlizzCon before. I have wanted to go for so long. I can't wait to go. I'm so excited. I have a question prepared for the Q&A panel when they do the kind of you know how they had that general Q&A class panel. I have a question for it. I'm gonna go up there and I'm gonna say to them, so the Elemental Shaman, traditionally, the Elemental Shaman, and the Shaman in general, has suffered from a balance of power. Early on in the expansion, the Shaman tends to be quite weak, due to a lot of their mechanics. For instance, multi-strike, and the reliance on having lots of multi-strike in haste in order to increase in power. And then, near the at the end of an expansion, the Shaman tends to be quite strong. And all that stuff, right? So what are you going to do to balance out that kind of that spike in power? How are you going to make it more consistent from the get-go? Because 6 months worth of grind and slog and terribleness is not worth... It's just not worth it, right? Unless you're really into the class like I am. So I'll make that a smaller question, but that's the question I'm going to ask. To kind of basically ask them, so how are you going to balance it out? How are you going to make the Shaman more even, as opposed to having it be a slant like that? You just get stronger and stronger, or I suppose it's that way for you guys. You get stronger and stronger as the expansion goes on. So that's going to be my question. Thank you all for your wonderful support. I'm so excited. It still hasn't hit me yet. I don't know what I'm going to do. Like, I don't know anything about it. But I am super excited for it. I really am. It's going to be amazing. I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be the highlight of this year, because the rest of this year has sucked. And it's going to make this year awesome. What's great is, right, this is what's going to happen. November comes along, we go to BlizzCon, we get back, Fallout 4 is released, which I'm super excited for, and then my mother will be visiting for Thanksgiving. November's going to be an amazing month. I'm so excited for it. So yeah, that's going to happen. Obviously, not going to be many videos for a while, so exciting. So question is, do you guys want to see videos of BlizzCon? Like, I have no idea what I'd even record. But I don't know. I mean, like, I might just buy, like, a camera and just, like, tell my husband, hold this! And just, I do stuff. I don't know. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be so exciting. I have no idea. We might just make it a thing where we just do stuff together. And maybe the only recording I'll get is when I ask my question. Hopefully I'll get in the line early and stuff like that. But what's also going to be exciting is Will Wheaton is going to be there. Now, if you don't know who Will Wheaton is, he's actually an actor who played Wesley Crusher in the Star Trek Next Generation series. And Will Wheaton is, like, the ultimate nerd. He is awesome. I can't wait. He's going to be commenting the different contests, the community contests. So that's exciting. That's so exciting. Yes, it's exciting. I doubt anyone's going to recognize me. I'm a small person, but I'm super excited about meeting Day 9. He's a huge inspiration of mine. Can't wait to see him. Maybe I'll bump into Jesse Cox as well, who's also awesome. I'm so excited. It's going to be awesome. So awesome. So I'm just going to scroll up quickly because KillerShot1998 asks, hi Tuskeh, is Guild Wars worth playing? Been trying to play other MMOs but have not found a good one. Yes. Guild Wars 2 is so worth it. It takes a learning curve to get into it. Because if you're a WoW player, you'll struggle to get into it because of the way it plays. But, like, you will get into it. And once you do, it's awesome. And right now, it's completely free. No subscription fee ever. And no fee to download it. You can literally go to guildwars2.com right now, make an account, and you can play what I'm playing right now. And that's cool. There's hundreds of hours of content in this game. So yeah, BlizzCon, super, super excited. I don't know if Preacher's going or not. He did just have a child, so I don't know. But yeah, I'm so excited. So let's calm down a bit now. And we've been going for about 50 minutes. What we'll do is we'll finish the completion of the Black Citadel. We'll go out into the world, do a little bit of combat. And then I think we'll go over to WoW or maybe another game after a quick break. But what we're going to do now is, this is the personal story. Now, your personal story, it's kind of like a BioWare story. You make decisions that affect how the story goes. Not to the same degree, but you do make decisions, and a lot of how the story starts depends upon your character creation choices. So you say, like, I am in this part of the military of the Char. This is how I handle situations. This is my, like, my warband mate, things like that. So, this is the first part of the personal story. In the prologue, my warband, like the group that I'm with, got decimated. Me and one other person are the only survivor. And we've been called, we got a mail here from the leader of the legion that we're in, that we have to deal with it and get a new warband and rebuild it. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to make myself disappear, and then we're going to watch this, because this is actually a cutscene. Which is really cool. So I'll just drag this up here to make myself disappear. And then I'll mute myself, and here we go.
We're the only ones left, I think. Lucky we made it out. Near as I can tell, everybody's at some kind of briefing at the mustering ground.
At ease, soldier. Damn shame that the Battle of Smokestead nearly wiped out your warband. Without you, Baradin would be stomping our skulls by now.
Yes, Tribune. I owe my survival to Ritlock Brimstone. He held the line until reinforcements came to take out the Duke.
True. Still, Legionnaire Howe was lost in the fighting, so your warband needs a new leader. Congratulations, you're promoted to Legionnaire.
Thank you, Tribune. I'm ready for duty.
I have an operation for you. We have intel that the Flame Legion has infiltrated the Citadel. Their spies...
Excuse the interruption, Tribune. We have hostiles incoming, ready for battle. Guard Tribune Desert Grave.
Lights out! We're under attack! Victory or death!
Well done, Legionnaire. You're already proving your worth. As for you, Fengar, do you need to go back to the Farrar and relearn basic perimeter security?
Sentries won't mess up again now that they're dead. And, I'll get new ones. You're lucky I was here, Fengar. The real question is, was this an attack of opportunity? Or is the Flame Legion planning something?
They know we're onto them. Those miserable flame rats. All they did was verify our intel. Their blunder's our chance. Here's your mission, Legionnaire. Go to the Serrated Blade Tavern and ask about Black Citadel Brandy. Your contact will say the barkeep waters it down. I'm told some flame sympathizers spend their time there. Discover who they are, and find something I can use to derail their plans. Questions?
None. I'll be quick and quiet, Tribune.
So that is the personal story. So you go into these little instanced areas, and I'll just put this back up here. Come on. There we go. Oh, and you go into these instance areas and you have little things like this. And that was just a little example of the combat there, a little ambush by the enemy legion. They're called the Flame Legion. And yeah, that's the personal story. It's pretty cool. To you guys in the EU who are saying you can just go over to the US, be wary, because this is an action-based game and lag destroys the experience. It really does. And that really sucks. So I'm just going to go here and get these last points of interest. And then we'll be done. I'm just going to go back to my hammer here, because hammer! Rawr, hammer. And someone earlier asked if you can swap out between your two weapon sets on the fly. Yes, you can. You can do it in combat. When you do it in combat, it has a 7 or 8 second cooldown. That's pretty cool stuff. That's the basic story of it. And the story actually changes depending upon what character creation stuff you pick. So if you... There are three legions, right? Three kind of main military wings in the Char. They're the Ash Legion, the Iron Legion, and the Blood Legion. The Ash Legion are spies, the Iron Legion are engineers, they make stuff, and the Blood Legion are soldiers. Oh, whoops. Just gotta go through that. There we go, okay, we're fine. Those are the three legions, and depending upon which one you pick at the start of the game, you get an entirely different story. If you picked the Blood Legion storyline, you would have got a story that involved a legionnaire who's in charge of your warband that sucks, and you basically taking it from him by force. If you'd been in the Iron Legion, it would be about dealing with ghosts using a special new invention that you have. And in the Ash Legion, it's about dealing with a war between the Flame Legion and the other legions by basically finding their spies and outspying them. So there's a lot of kind of cloak and dagger stuff, which is pretty cool. Final Wolfpack says, Tuskeh, I have too much pizza. Would you like some? I'm not in the mood for pizza right now. Although, actually, maybe I am. I'm always in the mood for pizza. But that's okay. You have it. We are nearly done with the Black Citadel. There's just one more point of interest in my series. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, no, we got them all. All right, we should be able to just leave by pressing this button. And we should get it. So, that's pretty cool. That's a bit of Guild Wars 2. We'll do a little bit of combat before we end this section and have a quick break. So here we go. Here is our reward chest. So we gain some experience and transmutation charges. This is a good time to talk about the transmog system. So you see, I gain experience just by wandering around. And yes, cloak and dagger as a tiger who breathes fire. I am, this is the sneakiest thing ever. But yeah, it's completely unrelated to what class you play. You can play a warrior that runs around with a hammer and, roars and smashes stuff up, and you can still be an Ash Legion spy. They just haven't restricted it in that regard. It requires a bit of suspension of disbelief, but yeah, as a tiger who breathes fire, I can be sneaky. It's brilliant. Here's a little tip. If you do get into this game and you do the personal story, you need to play... when you get to a point where you choose between three orders, the Vigil, the Dermond Priory, and the Order of Whispers, go with the Order of Whispers. Because the character that you meet through the Order of Whispers is the best character in this entire game. He's hilarious and brilliant. So that's my advice. And yes, it's exactly like a Tauren Rogue. You don't expect it, that's why it works. So what we're going to do now is we'll open up our map. Actually, oh no, transmog system, right. So this is my hero panel. From here, I can manage my equipment here. Here's all my equipment. I can manage my dyes, so I can hear all the dyes. Here are the locked ones. You get them in all kinds of different ways. And I can just change the color of any of my armor. That's not a good color to use to explain. Let's go with red. So here it is. I can change the color of all my armor. Here's another cool thing. You can actually disable the views on some of your pieces of armor. So you can hide your helmet, you can hide your shoulder pads, and you can hide your gloves if you wanted to. So I could just be this kind of, this light skirmishing dude who only wears like a chainmail vest. Or you could be like full Hulk armor, stuff like that. This is a kind of low level gear. It's like only like level 15, but it looks pretty good. So that's pretty cool. Here's the best part though. The wardrobe. This is a transmog system. This works just like Diablo 3. So you click on an armor. Let's say we want to change our shoulder pads. Click on that. And here are all of the things that my account has unlocked in terms of armor. So you just click on it and it will change. It will give you a preview of what it looks like, right? I've got some higher level stuff here. You can transmog higher level into lower level and lower level into high level if you want, which is really cool. So I could change all of this stuff here, and then I just go through here and change it all into the reinforced scale items. And then I just change that and that. And you see, it just changes the look of the whole armor set. And this looks pretty cool, doesn't it? There we go. Pretty nice. Is there a banded set that I have here? No, okay. But you can do all kinds of stuff like that. And for each piece that you change, you can also, of course, transmog your weapons into all kinds of cool stuff. This is a kind of an Asuran mace that I found. I've got a Norn mace here, and a Char mace, and just a good old iron hammer. And you can do it with everything. I mean, even like the torches that you wield. Like, this is an offhand torch. You can have it just be a generic torch, a special ornamental one, a Asuran one, or like an electric one, and it all looks really cool. And yes, WoW is switching to this transmog system, which is great. I'm so excited for that. But here's the caveat. To transmog, you have to spend transmutation charges. You see, I don't have enough transmutation charges. You buy them through the store, which sounds like it sucks. However, you can make transmutation charges and you can earn them. So you can transmog entirely through the game without buying anything. And dyeing your armor doesn't cost any transmutation charges either. But if you want to speed it up, you can buy them. And if you see here, I have 700 gems right now. And if I just go here to my transmog window. Buy more. You'll see to buy 5 is 150. Let's say you wanted to buy 25 for 600 gold. And you wanted to buy gems here. So 600 gold is like 600 gems. That's less than $10. So you could do that. I don't recommend it. I mean, you don't have to play this game like that. But that's just what you can do. You can kind of just speed things up like that. It's a very fair free-to-play model, I think. Potters asks, Tuskeh, have you ever tried out the game Warframe? No, I haven't. I'm not all that interested in it, to be honest. I don't know why. I'm just not. This is a... And it is kind of... It's not free transmog, but you can earn it. Rather than buying it. So that's fine. So what we'll do now is we're in the Diessa Plateau. This is like the Char farmland area. So what you can do is you can just start wandering around. There's actually a world event going on right now which has people invading our territory, which I don't want to get into just yet. So what we'll do is we'll actually go to a new zone. It's a little bit lower than what I have right now. But here's the thing. You are scaled at all times down. So I'm about to go into a level 1 to 15 zone. I'm level 21. You see here in the bottom left, it should be just underneath my webcam. Yep, you can see it there. Your level has been adjusted to match the area you are in. So you can never out-level an area. My husband has leveled from level 1 to level 40 just by doing all of the starting zones. And of course it gets harder as you level up because the enemies become a bit tougher in comparison. But you can easily just level up wherever you want. You can go anywhere. It doesn't matter. So let's talk about the questing system now quickly. Because I want to get into combat. Let's go over to here to all this icy stuff. Because there'll be lots of combat over here. So the questing system in this game is very, very interesting. And no, I'm not a West Ham fan. I don't like football. My family is a Chelsea team, but I don't like football. Or soccer, as you Americans call it. So, here is the heart for here. To complete this heart, to complete this quest, essentially, I have to raid the territory controlled by the Sons of Svanir and destroy all signs of their dragon's corruption. This is all this stuff here. So I can, I can kill them. I can, set their stuff on fire. I can rescue prisoners. I can do an event that spawns here. All that stuff. So it's a very robust system in that regard. So here we'll go into combat. So I'm just going to throw a torch at this guy to burn him. And I think he's ranged, so he'll... Here's another thing you can do. You can evade attacks. You see, I've got an energy bar here. And while you're evading, you're briefly immune. They're called invulnerability frames. So I'll do that again just to show you. So I'll go over to this guy and hit him. Like, yeah, come here. So you see, I got hit there by his spinny attack. So he'll come over to me and then he'll hit me again. Here we go. Smack, he's hitting me. But if he hits me and I dodge, you see like that. Actually, I didn't do that very well. I'll do this again. It takes a bit of getting used to, okay? I'm just going to kill this guy. Melee attacks are more difficult to dodge than... ranged attacks are easy to dodge, sorry. Here's a bolt thrower. I'll just dodge that attack. So I'll just go in here and ruin these guys' day. I'm just going to swap to my other thing and smack. Smackity smack. Destroy this stuff. Yeah. So I'll try and find a proper example. And yeah, it is like the Apex's dailies. Except for the whole game and a bit better designed. So this Son of Svanir has a... He has a staff, so he'll be attacking me from range. So here we go. Here's this thing. It's going to hit me and just deal damage. I actually blocked it because of a passive of mine. But here you see he's hitting me, and someone's helping me here. This is the interesting part. All enemies in this game are shared. Like, there's no tagging system at all. So that guy will get loot just like me, and he'll get experience just like me. Other players here are a good thing, not a bad thing. So that's fantastic. So here's another guy. I think he has a bow, maybe? Aggro, you silly... There we go. So he's hitting me. He's just going to fire arrows at me. Next time he fires, I'll just evade backwards. Oh, here we go. I'll get it right, I promise. Shoot me! There we go. I evaded it, see? And then I won't be able to evade this time because I don't have enough energy. But there are different ways of restoring your endurance to kind of do things like that. So evading in this game is super important. If you evade at the right time, you can avoid loads of damage. This is also something that this game has that WoW doesn't. It has an awful lot of impact. I can do this. I can just knock guys around. I can just throw them around like it's nothing with my 4 ability. Like, it really makes you feel like the combat is really, really visceral, which is great. It's very action-based. There's a lot of dodging around. Sometimes you'll get screwed over by, like, elite and veteran enemies. But most of the time, you can take on multiple enemies, and if you do well, you can just avoid them all. So, So yeah, we're doing pretty well here. Let me just go to this area up here, because on my map here, there's a hero point. Now, hero points are... Aha! Here we go. Here's a whole bunch of enemies. So, let's go and fight them. So, we'll set ourselves on fire, put a symbol on the ground, breathe fire, because fire is really sneaky, dodge forward to dodge their attacks, kill this guy, swap to the Great Hammer, knock you away, spam! Kill you, smack you in the head, dodge those icicles, and then we'll root you so you can't run away, and then just use our auto attack to... smash you in the face. So you see, it's very slow, but it's also it's very visceral, this Great Hammer, and you can play like really fast weapons as well. But yeah, that's pretty cool. Well, where is this hero point? It's just over here. Maybe I can jump over. Maybe if I'm lucky. Maccas says, quick wild question, Tusky. How do you get good at raiding? By raiding. It's that simple. Experience is the most important thing. Don't be gun shy. Get in there. Go into pugs, find a guild, fail, and then learn from your failures. It's that simple. Just, like, constantly learn. And Potter says that I noticed from your other videos that you have Ori and the Blind Forest. I do. Ori and the Blind Forest is a beautiful game. I finished it. It's a very good game. I just loved it. So here's the hero challenge. This is, like, a challenge that might be, like, a riddle, or you might have to get to a certain place. Might be a jumping puzzle, or in this case, it might be a combat challenge. So here is a veteran. This guy's a bit tougher, but he's not immune to being knocked around. And we'll kill his crew members as well, because these guys are pretty nasty. And we're not actually taking too much damage, because we're regenerating ourselves with all of our hits, so we're pretty good. We'll breathe fire on him, because fire is the best thing. And then we'll just knock him around, and just use our abilities. And here's a cool thing, so I'll just use my warding ability and then roll away, and you see, he can't chase me, he can't go through it until it fades. Although he can still use abilities like that. So here's a blocking ability. So it blocks it and then damages him if he hits me, which is cool. There's all kinds of stuff like that. I'm not playing a particularly high damage build at the moment, which is why this is taking a while. You can be very glass cannon in this game, and gear is fairly important, but only really at the maximum level. So, yes, I am the Dragon Kitty, although the Elementalist has better dragon abilities than I do. So, this is this is Guild Wars 2. I've been enjoying it a lot. It's just a game that I kind of get lost in because the atmosphere in it is really good. And, like, the music and just the sounds of it are all really cool. So what I'm going to do here is I'll finish this heart, and then we'll take a quick break, and then we will, we'll do something else. So let's get a great sword out and just cleave some bad guys up. So I have an ability here that fires out these spectral swords, and then I can pull enemies to me. We'll just dodge that, and then just whirlwind our way, spin to win, as it said, and then just cleave them all to death. So the great sword's a bit faster than the hammer. But yeah, and someone suggests Counter-Strike could go. I've never played that game, nor am I interested in it. So, I'm afraid that's not going to happen. And so yeah, you've got all these kind of different abilities. And there we go. Finished it, you get a whole bunch of experience. And then you get a little thing that says like, your raids on the Sons of Svana have been a huge help. Thanks. And then you get Karma, which is a currency, and a bit of gold. And there we go. So that's Guild Wars 2. What we'll do now is I think we'll take a quick break and I will decide what we're going to do next. Also, Mr. Phantom asks, Guild Wars 2 is not free to play? Yes, it is. Guild Wars 2 is completely free. There's no subscription fee and there is no... there's no anything. Like, the expansion Heart of Thorns costs money to buy, but right now the base game, which is what I have right here, is free completely and utterly. You can go to guildwars2.com right now and download it. And that's it. You'll be done. So... it is completely free right now, and this is why I'm playing it, because I just want to, like, let you guys know that there is an alternative out here that, again, doesn't mean you don't love WoW, it was ridiculous if you think like that. Just enjoy yourself. So, that will conclude this. There's an event going on right now. I'm not going to get involved, because it'll take, like, 20 minutes, but yes. So, I'm just going to take a quick break, and then we will move on to something else. Maybe some Heroes of the Storm? Maybe you guys would like to play. That'd be fun. But until then, about a quick 5-minute break. So, Yosh, thank you very much for watching this first part, and then we shall move on. Where's my hymn? Here we go. Okay. Well, damn it. It seems like you people want to see me suffer. So, we call this Elemental Shaman PvP. Oh boy. Alright, I'm logging into WoW, just let me get it all shit up for you folks, and then we shall do that. Thank you for voting on the straw poll, and, oh god. Oh god. This is going to be interesting. Elemental Shaman PvP struggles right now, to say the least. So what we'll do is I'm just going to turn this on, and then wait for it. BAM! Wait. It broke, guys. I broke the thing. Why did the thing break? Hello? Hello, video game? Okay. What's great is that my stream's also broken. Well, my stream, the one I'm watching, is broken. So let me try this again. I will fix this. Don't worry, I will fix this! Do this! This is the professional quality you can come to expect. Aha! Sorted! Okay, fantastic. Here I am, in WoW. I've got to adjust my webcam, because I'm super professional and I was 100% prepared for this. There we go. And my throat is dying horrifically. But we'll be fine. Okay, so, Elemental Shaman PvP. This is a thing that you do. So, we'll do some battlegrounds, and what your goal in a battleground is, as an Elemental Shaman, is to get flame shocks on everyone and rely upon Lava Surge procs to deal damage. So we'll be using Echo of the Elements to get as many lava bursts out as we can. We'll go with Storm Elemental Totem just because the CC is nice and Elemental Fusion isn't really worth it. It just doesn't do enough damage. Frozen Power for kiting people. Ancestral Guidance might be helpful here and there. And of course Primal Elementalist so we can use it for the CC. The rest of it just isn't worth it. So, Glyphs, we will be using... Thunder, because when we get attacked by enemies, we need to Thunderstorm them away frequently, and Thunderstorm baseline has a 45-second cooldown, which is ridiculous. Glyph of Ghost Dwarf, because slows are everywhere, and this will help mitigate them. And a Glyph of Shamanistic Rage, which makes me dispel harmful magic effects, which is a good way to either kill myself if I dispel Affliction Warlock stuff, or just like get rid of Hammer of Justices and stuff along that line. So I have a PvP set right here. It's probably going to be terrible in terms of transmog. Kind of is. This is a kind of a mishmash of stuff. I'm not doing too great in terms of this gear. But it'll have to do. We'll have to transmog quickly because this is just... Oh, it's horrible. There we go. Much better. Okay. And we will get our new shield. We have a new shield that actually looks really nice with this set. We got it from... Mythic Socrathar. Look at that. Isn't that cool? It actually fits the Dark Shaman transmog almost perfectly. Nice. All right, we'll keep that. All right, so. Let's just queue. I've vetoed Isle of Conquest in Alteric Valley because I hate massive battles like that. Okay. Okay, so that guy asks, one thing I have to ask, why Horde? And on top of that, why only Horde? Multi-faction is the best thing, at least for me. I agree, multi-faction is the best way to experience the game. However, I just haven't been able to get into the Alliance. I don't know why. Maybe it's because I used to be a role player and I got really devoted to the Horde. I just don't know. I tried leveling Alliance characters, I just can't do it. I just get bored. Like, I don't know what it is. I have no hatred for the Alliance, no genuine hatred anyway, but... I don't know. I honestly don't know. So when it comes to PvP, expect me to fuck up a lot. Expect me to make terrible mistakes. And okay, so we've entered an in-progress battleground. The Alliance have 920 to our 400, and they have our flag. All right, there's the flag carrier. Let's just go for the flag carrier. We'll just pop Bloodlust and go crazy. So again, our biggest issue right now is just getting as many shocks out as we can. All right, so that went well. We'll move our totem forward, and we want to try and avoid attention if we can. And then if we get attention on us, to move it around. So we'll purge some of his magic effects. He's out of our line of sight. There's a healer over there, and enemies to our left, so we'll just run this way. It looks like we'll try and focus this warlock down a bit, although that doesn't seem to be working. We'll throw out a capacitor totem, and then use our cooldowns. We'll get this guy in the air. I'm using a special macro to throw these guys up into the air. You see, look at all those lava surges. That's how you PvP as an elemental shaman. You spread those lava bursts just to try and get as many lava bursts as you can. So I tremor totemed that fear over there just to help our guys out. Remember, you still have a lot of utility. We'll just keep moving forward. This is a little bit awkward. We'll get down our other totems there. Make sure you always flame shock hunter pets as well. They never cleanse hunter pets. It's a really good way of getting stacks. So we're just ruining this guy's day. Just lava burst after lava burst after lava burst. That's the idea of it all. It's just you keep lava bursting. Never end. Never end. Lava bursts forever. I'll get a capacitor out there just to try and ruin the day a bit more. Looks like they are dispelling these, which kind of sucks. I don't have Tremor Totem for that particular fear. We got an enhanced chain lightning, so we'll get that out. This is a Disciplined Priest. He'll never die, so... they've actually got two Disciplined Priests, so this kind of sucks. We'll get another one out there. And it looks like he's attacking. But that's okay. That's just fine. I can't beat a Disciplined Priest in a one-on-one fight. You just won't be able to do it. You see this guy, his health... I just fired two Lava Bursts in his face and his health hasn't moved. So we'll just get out of the way of this guy and just move along. Potters asks, after this round, mind if I join you? Go ahead. You go ahead. I don't mind in the slightest. You'll probably be better than me. So we'll just go around this direction. The Alliance have two of the three bases and they're about to win. So it looks like... I'm still in combat. Damn. Looks like this nothing interesting is happening. This is probably just a lost match. And also remember Healing Surge. Healing Surge is really important. So we'll just wander around there. So the Elemental Shaman can do well if you're, like, not constantly under attack. They're not very good at peeling for themselves, and by that I mean, like, if you get attacked, then you just have to, like, pray and run. You can't really do your damage rotation. It's a lot about the way you... It's luck, basically. It's the amount of lava surges you get. As you can see, you can do some damage if you get lucky with lava surges. If you don't, then you're kind of screwed. So there are loads of Alliance everywhere, and my team is just in scatters. I'm just going to kind of wander around and not die. This is something that's interesting. I'll just flame shock this guy. He reflected it into my face. That's nice. Well, Shamanistic Ranger out. But yeah, this is actually something that's interesting, is a lot of the time you have to think about not engaging. There we go. We lost. But that was only our warm-up game. It was a mulligan game. So Potters asks if he can join us. Go ahead. Feel free to just throw me your battle tag. Potters 2. So there we go. That didn't count. Okay, guys. My inventory is a complete mess right now. I got... none of the gear that I'm going to get from this is any good, because it's all like 700. My mythic gear even though it downscales, it will downscale to a higher item level than this stuff. So, yeah. Potters says he's already on my battle tag. It's okay. Okay, we'll do that. We'll do that. I'm just gonna turn on my face cam quickly so that I can get this sorted out without showing you all my battle tag and getting spammed, because I don't want to do that. Alright, I've invited him to the group, and... Where is it? Where is it? There it is! Okay, fantastic. So we are now with Potters, who is, looks like an enhancement shaman. Fantastic. Alright, let's do this. Nope, I want to join as a group. There we go. Okay, so a lot of people have been saying that the only way you can PvP as an elemental shaman is to go resto. Which has some truth to it, I will admit. So World of Warcraft. I need to change some stuff on Twitch. Okay, there we go. So, yeah, that kind of concludes Tea Time with Tuskeh. Now we're just kind of relaxing for a while, having some fun. Because I need it. After all that crap that's happened, I need a bit of fun. I need a vendor as well, is also what I need, just to sell some this stuff. Am I still using my decent one? I am. Okay, fantastic. Etherfrost says, Tuskeh, are there any add-ons that you consider essential to being a good raider? Yes, I would say you would need either bigwigs or deadly boss mods and weak auras. That's it. If you learn those two add-ons, you should be fine. Deadly boss mods and bigwigs, either, you don't need both. Either of them will show you everything you need to know about raid timers and all that crap. And weak auras is amazing. It's the best add-on ever. It lets you present any information in the world. If I type slash weak auras, you'll see I have a ton of weak auras here. And they just show me stuff, really, that, you know, just information. Like, this is the Eye of Anzu, this is a bunch of raiding debuffs. Here's my lightning shields missing, my searing totems missing, my stacks of fulmination, my cooldowns, all kind of stuff like that. It's all just really helpful. And yes... As Cersei says, everyone's going to be judging us, Potters. Let's not screw this up. Are we prepared? This is going to be painful. I'm going to eat some multi-strike food as well. But yeah, a nameplate add-on is useful. Yeah, not mandatory, I'd say. Very useful. But there are a lot of add-ons that are just useful for raiding as opposed to mandatory. Weak auras and a boss mod are mandatory, in my opinion. And other than that, just stuff that helps you play smoothly and gives you information are good. So quartz is good for seeing your cast bar down here. Tidy plate's good for seeing nameplates. Voodoo is great for seeing your raid frames and stuff like that. We'll stick together. That's what we're typing in group chat. Let's stick together. Shaman power. But yeah, generally, weak aura is fantastic. Shattered unit frames is what I'm using for my unit frames to the left and the right here, which is really cool. So this is me, this is my target, this is my target of target. And then I can also do, like, focus target and things like that. So it's pretty cool. So, oh boy, everyone's going to die. but yeah, generally, what you want to do is you want to get the flame shocks out. Lava burst, that you don't want to sit there and cast. Like, lava burst if you get lava surge. Use the rest of the time just keeping enemies off of you, mostly. And the rest of the time, you just kind of hope. So I'll get some of the old water walking. Water walking is also very good in places like this. So here we go. I haven't even looked at the alliance. Warrior, Shaman, Rogue, Death Knight, Rogue, Mage, Paladin, Shaman, Monk, Hunter. Okay, it looks like they're going to intercept us as we go along here. So this is going to be interesting, to say the least. Well, it looks like they're actually backing off a bit now. That's okay. And you don't want to fight in the middle, generally. You want to go for their flag. I'm going to go for the flag, so I'm probably going to die really fast. But that's okay. I have a shield, which will help. And I have a few ways of mitigating damage and getting the hell out of places. So that's what we'll do. Okay. So it looks like the rogue is actually going to go for it. All right, you go ahead. You go ahead, mate. We're with you. We will defend you. Okay. So Tillman is the person we have to defend. Let's go. Let's do it. Fantastic. We'll have to defend him from bad guys. This is a great place to fight as an elemental shaman because you can thunderstorm people down this cliff on the left. I will demonstrate what I mean in just a moment like that. Oh, I nearly got him. All right, so let's get going. So we want to... We'll use our Spirit Walker's Grace here and just unload everything we have onto this warrior just to ruin his day. All right, warrior is down. Now we'll go onto the rogue. Bit less of a smart idea to focus a rogue because they can use their immunities like that. So we'll just... Oh, we hit a Spirit Wolf there instead of the actual shaman. Looks like Tillman's doing fine. That's good. When you don't get targeted, you can do some decent damage. Let's see if we can ruin these people's day over here. We'll head over here just to stop them from getting towards our rogue, who is now in our base, actually, which is good. We'll just start flame shocking people and back off a little bit and just let the flame shock tick. So here we go. We've got lots of lava surges at this point, so we can get lava surge after lava surge. This warrior's probably going to go for me. Yep. So we'll use our trinket on him and then back off, and then we'll get a grounding totem out. Accidentally hit that. That's fine. We're okay. We'll get a couple of purges out just to make him a bit weaker. Again, want to back off a little bit here. Getting lots of lava surge procs, that's what we want. Gonna get our spirit, our capacity totem out. And here comes the stun. Big stun incoming. 10 seconds on our thunderstorm, which is good. This paladin is going for me, but he doesn't seem to be having much luck. So we'll just keep him out of the way. A good capacitor totem, I think, from our friend there, actually, helped with that. Okay, we've got a Restoration Shaman now, so we'll Hex her. And all right, we're now being focused, so we'll use an Astral Shift to try and just kind of move away. And get down another Earthbind Totem here. We're going to go onto the Resto Shaman here just to try and make her life more difficult. Just to kind of pressure her. Make sure we want to interrupt her as soon as she starts casting a spell. There it is. Oh, someone else got the interrupt first. That's good. That's good. She should be screwed now. Yep, there we go. She is dead. We'll get some more casts out here. We'll get our capacitor totem over to that paladin. And just stun him there. Alright, getting the good damage out now. We're just getting a chance to cast away. And bang, 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 bang. He's dead. Alright, gonna always make sure, as I said, that you flame shock both the hunter and its pet. Because the pet will give you free lava surge procs. So there we go. We've defended this. Now we're going to go for their... What he calls it, for their flag. So let's continue. Bubbleboy asks, have you ever played StarCraft 2? I have. I have done the campaign on both of them. It's good fun. Multiplayer? Nope. I'm terrible at it. So let's go for their flag. Potters is right behind us. We shall charge forth into their keep. There's a dwarf warrior in the way. He looks like he's backing off a little bit. Tillman seems to be okay. He's the guy who has our flag. Some people respawning behind us. Are they going to circle around on us? Looks like they are. We'll put that there so people know that we've got incoming behind us. It looks like there's a big group of people here. So we're going to want to be careful. We want to get our grounding out for the inevitable stun that's coming out. We'll dispel his blessing of freedom when we get the chance. There we go. And we'll just keep going this way. And we will get him out of the way. Okay, now we have a chance to do some damage over here. So let's get our ascendants out. Hopefully they're not too far. It looks like they are. Alright, we'll have to go down. This sucks, but it is the way of things. We'll use Ancestral Guidance here to try and help out. There's a lot of bad guys here. Going to get as many of these things out as we can. Ah, we got the Alliance flag. We were able to actually get the guy. Alright, so now we're in serious trouble. So we're going to back out now if we can. It looks like we've got a paladin on us who is going to continue to chase us here, which really sucks. He's got immunity to all of our abilities, which is going to make this very painful. So we're going to try and sneak him around and thunderstorm him in that direction as he tries to stun us. So we'll back off in this direction and we'll use some healing surges in addition to our pot just to keep him off us. And we'll get our primal elementals out there. And he's used another watcher calls it. And now he's in range. This is kind of sucky. But we now have the root on him. We'll keep going. Keep going. Got to keep going. Never surrender. Never give up. We'll just keep moving, trying to get out of his range. Looks like he's starting to give up now, which is great. Oh no, he's back after us again. And we want to... Don't get stunned. Ah, there's the stun. But we can thunderstorm him away, which is great. That was a good thunderstorm. Okay, we're now going to... I think we're now going to start applying a bit of pressure to him. So we've got this execution sentence on us. We don't want to get hit by that. It looks like he's going to be just out of range of our stun. And he's got some good damage on us now, which sucks. But we're just going to... We'll probably have to self-res. Yep, we'll do that. Self-res and continue the fight. Now that we're back at a decent amount of health, we should be able to pressurize this paladin into death, basically. So, oh, looks like Potters is with us as well. Potters saving the day. So that kind of sucks, but looks like Tillman's back over there. That was a big, long fight, that. Very difficult to get away from them with all those silly long-ranged Hammer of Wraths of his doing lots of damage. All right, so it looks like Tillman's in trouble over here. Maybe we can do something to help him out. So we will... Oh, looks like they reset the flag here. So we'll grab it and just make a beeline for the door. Run! Run away! Okay. So we were able to sneak it out from behind them as they were chasing the other flag carrier, which is fantastic. Although now they're probably going to flank us. So we're going to have to think about thunderstorming off of them, off of this cliff. That self-res there was very important. All right. I see what looks like a Death Knight over there. And it looks like they're not actually coming over here, which is interesting. That's probably something you should do, Alliance people. Alright, we'll get an Earthbind Totem out and project it over to the other side, just to slow that guy down, or make him force him to walk around it. So I don't actually know what that guy is. I've got to get a mouse over going. Ah, got stuck on a rock. I am the best PvPer. Alright, I've been sapped. That's okay. We'll just wait. There's no point in using our trinket now when we could be in much more danger later. So we'll get a Grounding Totem out, just to help avoid the inevitable frost shock that comes from this shaman. Another sap has come out. We're nearly immune, so that's fine. We want to be patient. It's frustrating to get sapped by a rogue, but it's also not the end of the world. All right, so here comes the Death Knight. I've been blinded. It's okay. We're still going to wait. Okay, now they're opening on me. Now is where I want to start using my defenses. So I'm going to run away. I'm going to use my capacitor totem to just build a bit of distance. Going to project it forwards. And looks like she's going to jump on me, but that's okay. I'm going to use my ancestral guidance, and now this is where I want to use my thing. And as you can see, here's the problem. All right, just give me a second. Looks like our wonderful healer is being wonderful, but we are completely surrounded by enemies here, which sucks. So we're just going to keep moving. It was a great capacitor totem from our friend there. I've been stunned into a comet, which is going to really suck. More stuns. There's just so much stuns. Going to thunderstorm everyone away, and then going to drink just to try and help a little bit. It's probably not going to help, because we're in serious trouble here. I have no cooldowns left. Looks like we're probably going to lose this. I'll just try and move away to try and get it into someone else's. Just stay in range of this damn healer, mostly. Get the capacitor out, and maybe it'll be enough to save us. And oh my god, we might actually live through this. Capacitor is out. Going to interrupt that polymorph. Here comes the warrior to ruin our day, and we are actually alive. I cannot believe this. Whoever is healing me is an absolute baller. So we'll just get some casts out now. Now that we're safe with the alliances on the retreat, we'll just keep moving. And we actually survived that. Oh my god. I cannot believe that was a thing that happened. That was great. Who's this guy? We'll just say that. That was amazing healing. I am so surprised that we got away with that. But yeah, I was just very surprised there. Clever use of our... Had we used the trinket earlier to break that stun, we probably would have died up in that kidney shot that was 6 seconds long. So there was an argument to use it earlier to get more distance on them, but we don't actually have the flag on our base right now, so it's important that we just wait for now. But yeah, that was amazing. All right, so it looks like we've got a shaman over here, and looks like this person is engaging on our priest, so it looks like we're in danger here, so we'll use our cooldowns here just to try and get some damage out on these guys. They're on us. We'll get the capacitor totem out, use as many of our cooldowns as we can just to try and survive this. We want to make sure we stay in range and in line of sight of our healer, so we want to get as much of this out as we can. Use our trinket just to back off a little bit. Yeah, enhancement shaman, as you can see, very nasty there. And oh, there we go, just burst down there. We were out of cooldowns there, so they're probably going to capture now. We were able to get their flag at the same time, so that kind of that was good. Looks like there are still people fighting in the middle of the map, so we can give them a hand, but there's no real point at this point. We just want to actually the rogue with the flag looks like he's pretty good right now. We have a lot of fighting going on over here. What we want to do though is we want to get our flag back. Looks like no one's actually on the flag. There it is. I believe it's... Okay, it's a rogue, so we're probably going to expect to get blinded as we go over. So we're going to put our... We want to slow him down. That's our first goal, is to slow him down. So we've got the frost shock out. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. No path available, as always. Really frustrating. But that's okay. We'll just continue this. That thunderstorm botched, but that's okay. We'll just continue harassing him until the rest of the people can get here. Looks like they're being harassed over here. Right now, this shaman's just going to kill me because I'm not focusing on him. Although, probably he'll kill me anyway. See what we can do here to kind of save ourselves. Going to drink potion again. See what we can do here. Going to back off a little bit. Might actually be able to get away from this. Get onto the water with our water walking. Oh, we are completely surrounded. Fantastic. Just what I've always wanted. I love being completely surrounded. I think that might be it for us. We'll get one more thunderstorm out before we die. It won't do much anyway. Tried to go onto that rogue, but I was the only one on the team who was going for it, so unfortunately we didn't get it. But we are still leading the game. There's only 3 minutes left in this game, so if we hold on like this, we will win, because the last team that scores gets the win. I believe that's the way it works anyway. So we're still getting lava surges, actually, from the flame shocks that we have on people. So we'll head this way and just get a couple of lava surges out on this guy. Where is the Alliance flag right now? Okay, it's down there. And oh, he's under attack. Oh, we actually got... Okay, maybe we can help this rogue. Gotta just try and help, really. Gonna spread the flame shock around. Gonna thunderstorm this guy away from our... That didn't work. Damn thunderstorm. Just gotta try and get him away from this healer. This healer is important. So we'll get some damage out and then finish him off with an earth shock. And that'll be the end of him. Alright, so this guy's after our rogue. We'll get in range and... ruin his day with a frost shock. Hi, mate. What you doing? What you doing? Are you going to go for me? You're going to go for me. I know you are. And get there. Okay. We're going to pop everything at this point and just nuke him down for the glory of the Empire. And we're doing no damage because I don't know, but we are. There's no damage going on this guy. Oh, there's the damage. There's the damage we were expecting. All right. We're going to thunderstorm him away now and then hit him with that. We should expect to get death gripped at some point. There it is. Okay, we're going to use our healing abilities at this point and then project the totem into his face. We're both stunned and we're both going to trinket. Okay, now I have a bit of an advantage because now I can CC him with my totem. So I need to make sure I don't get... Okay, this guy is healing really hard. I have to be very careful here. So we'll drink along with a healing surge and then just going to keep kiting him. Although he can still damage us from range, so we may just be boned. Oh no, Potters comes in to save the day. That's my strategy. That is my strategy with this, yeah. Alright, we'll head this way, and we'll see if we can stop this flag from being turned in. We're still in combat, though, which is a bit of an annoyance, but that's okay. We'll wait for combat to end. There it is. We'll try and grab the horde flag before it gets too far out of the base. Got to keep an eye on which direction it's coming from. Most people come out in this direction, although I honestly don't know where the flag is. We've got to... Oh, it's on the other side of the map. Oh, jeez. I was not expecting that. Looks like there was a big old slog that I just didn't notice. Okay, the Alliance flag has been returned to its base. Crap. Okay, we now have 1 minute to stop them from... Oh, Tillman! Okay, we've got to defend this guy for 55 seconds. If we can defend him, we win. Okay, if we can defend Tillman, we win. Let's do this. We have 45 seconds. If the Alliance don't score within those 45 seconds, we win. I think. So we've got to stay on top of this guy. Okay, getting disoriented, but that's okay. Just got to make sure she doesn't get on this guy. That's the most important thing. Gonna get a root out on this guy. Just got to defend him. That's all we've got to do is defend him. Get the capacitor out. And then we'll... Well, actually, we won't hex him. We'll interrupt you, and then we'll hex you just to ruin your day. We've got to keep Tillman alive. That is the absolute priority right now. And we're going to thunderstorm everyone away. 14 seconds. Come on, just going to spam heal Tillman here. Just do everything we can. No, it wasn't enough. It wasn't enough. There we go. That's an Alliance win, I believe. The Alliance just moved on to us. I don't think there was a healer here either. Oh, well. Damn, that was so very close. So very close. Oh, well. Which is a bit of a shame. And now we're going to get our 19 gold for all of that hard work. Jeez. You know, I've done about 100 battlegrounds since this quest started. I've won 2. It's ridiculous. So close. Oh well. Let's continue. Let's move on. And we'll hearth to Ashran to see what about buying some gear as well. T-Rex says, hello there, Mr. Tuskeh. Why not spec enhancement and do some arenas? Well, 1, I don't like arenas. And 2, I like elemental. And 3, I'm bad at enhancement. I'm sure chat is judging you, Potters. Yes. Terrible shame. Not as much as they're judging me. Okay, so what do we need? We need conquest gear mostly. That does involve arenas. I'll probably get my raid leader paladin to come and heal me through those because 2s is probably just not a good idea. We'll probably get owned. We could do 2s, maybe. I don't know. Let's just move on and do something else. So, that was very intense. Very intense. The Alliance just kind of bared down upon our rogue at the last second there, which is a bit of a shame. So, let's move on. Oh, lag spike there. Wow, the lag spikes are real. Come on. There we go. There's all those people joining the instance. All right, so let's move on. Just gonna move over there. Okay. So, who are we up against? Alliance players. We've got a warlock, a hunter, a priest. Is there any way to tell what piece they are? Oh, yeah, shadow priest, elemental shaman. They have an elemental shaman. Interesting. Subtlety, rogue, restoration druid, frost mage, beastmaster hunter, marksman hunter... Beastmaster Hunter, an Arms Warrior, and an Assassination Rogue. I actually wonder, is there any actual point to using this stuff anymore? I remember back in Wrath of the Lich King, this stuff hit really hard. But I don't know if it's worth it anymore. So are you going to do something else other than PvP? Well, we've only got about 17 minutes left of this particular stream, so I think we'll just PvP, do a couple more matches. And then we shall call it a day. Because I'm a bit tired, I have to admit. It's been a long day for me. Just in general, it's been a long two months or so. I see the Alliance ships. They're on the move. I'm going to farsight over to one of them. Bam! That didn't work. Damn, looks like you can't farsight over. Can I farsight this far? I can. Oh, there's a shark over there. I didn't know there were sharks in this battleground. That's cool. Alright, I can't do that. Okay. But he can mind vision. He's mind visioning me, interestingly enough. Okie dokie, here comes the Alliance. I don't know what my plan is here. Just area of effect, stun, bloodlust, and nuke the demolisher, I suppose. Here we go. Here comes the pain. The pain and misery awaits us. 3, 2, 1. Capacitor is out. 1. That's probably going to detonate too fast. Yeah, it did. Okay, nuke the demolishers! And get out of line of sight of everyone, because holy shit! I'm just gonna nuke this hunter, because I feel like nuking this hunter. Alright, Ascendance is up, let's nuke him. Actually, screw it, let's go for this hunter. This warrior instead. Die, warrior! Reflecting my own lava burst in my face, how dare you. Okay, this hunter's on me now. I'm just gonna go after him instead. Die, Hunter! Alright, and he's deflecting my shots. Gonna flame shock this guy. Get as many roots out as we can. There's so many of them. Oh, goodness gracious me. Alright, we can at least get a... Alright, we got the mage, guys. We got the mage. Most important thing. Alright, we're under attack. We're just gonna throw out the totem. This shadow piece is owning me, isn't she? Yeah, I'm probably going to die here. I'm just going to disrupt as much as I can before it inevitably happens. Oh, I'm getting healed. That's very nice. All right, we'll get that out there. We'll just use our immunities. And I like that. Our immunities. We'll just use our whatever we have. And just try and ruin their day, basically. I'm about to die, but maybe I can get one more flame shot. Nope. Okay. I don't really feel like I did much there. Thunder them into the water. That's probably what I should have done. I haven't really done this battleground much. I played it a bit during Wrath of the Lich King, but since then, God no. All right, so the Gate of the Moon has been destroyed. They're just running past. Let's root this guy, and then just there's so many of them. Oh goodness me! All right, well we'll just thunderstorm them all that way, I suppose. There's just they're everywhere. They're just literally everywhere. Where is everyone else? All right, let's just run away and see if we can survive at this point. Getting rooted again. Well, we'll root you again, mate. I can root you too. How do you feel about that? Yeah. But you don't like that, do you? I've been frozen. Oh, no! Can we get to the teleporter in time? Drink the thing! Nope. Damn it. Warriors and their executes for... How much did that hit me for? 80,000. Wish I could crit for 80,000. I actually literally... I kid you not. I once went up against a rogue who had so much... PvP gear that I lava bursted her for about 3k, and then she spammed her throw ability on me for 4k each. It's so sad, isn't it? It's so sad. Where are they? Alright, they just took the Gate of the Purple Amethyst. Looks like they're all just going for the left-hand side, which is a shame because there's actually someone on the right-hand side. Whoa! There was someone on the right-hand side there. Okay, so they're over here. It's not stopping! We'll just bloodlust again, and then see what we can do. Let's go for this hunter. Just gonna pick someone and spam lava burst in their face. 5, 4, 3, come on! More lava bursts! More lava bursts! More lava bursts! Got him! Ha ha! Got him! Alright, now we're under attack, so now we're in trouble. Let's just keep moving. We'll flame shock the battleground demolisher. Hopefully not get hit too badly. And we will thunderstorm. Okay, no we won't, because lag. I think lag anyway. Battleground Demolisher is nearly dead. Want to get out as many flame shocks as is humanly possible for all those sweet, sweet lava surges. Lava surge after lava surge after lava surge. That's the way we do it. That's the way. We'll just do that. And is there someone going for me now? I hope there's not. And we'll just dispel you a few times. Go over here and just kill this mage. Yeah! Hit you in the face. Oh, God, we got knocked away. Alright, and then we'll ruin this priest's day a little bit, I think. Just to make him use his trinket. There we go. Alright, made him use his trinket. Maybe I've got a mage on me? I don't know. I mean, the water elemental's on me, but I don't think that counts. Alright, getting the flame shocks out on everyone for all the lava surges. All the lava surges. All the lava surges. Come on, give me them lava surges. There we go, there's another lava surge, just to get some more damage out, more damage out, more damage out. There's 3 lava surges in a row. Alright, it looks like they're going for the end here. Why are people not hit? Okay, never mind. Alright, we'll trinket RA out of that, because we want to keep up the pain here. And then we'll lava surge you, we'll get a thunderstorm out, just to, like, ruins everyone's day. We need to stop them from getting there, if we can. Those aren't players, damn it, I thought that was a player. Okay, so let's ruin this guy's day. He spawned right in front of the graveyard. Kill him, guys! Kill him! Gotta keep an eye out for this. Keep a situational awareness going. Alright, got that guy. Here comes some more demolishers. And, I think this is the Elemental Shaman. Yeah! Hello, Elemental Shaman. How are you doing, mate? Well, I hope you're doing well. Okay. Let's just continue here. Use our cooldowns. Just try and stop them, mostly. That's all I'm doing. And I got horrified. I'm so scared of earth shocking you in the face. And then, come on. Gotta get those lava bursts out. And I want to get an opportunity to thunderstorm a whole bunch of people away. Is my bloodlust up yet? Nope. But this is, and bam! Get thunderstormed away. Oh, but we thunderstormed ourselves away, guys. Alright, so we're doing some good damage to this priest. Bam, 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 bam. Lava surge, lava surge, lava surge, lava surge, lava surge. I care not for your dispersion. I care not. Okay, getting some nice damage out there. Got the Ancient Protector. No idea what that is. Kill 10 players in the Courtyard of Ancients. Nice! Getting all the kills. Yeah! Holding the line. Loktaro Gar, brothers and sisters. Where do you think you're going? I'll tell you where you're not going, and it's over there. No unstable affliction for you. Gonna dispel this curse, because agony is where they get loads of damage from. And I don't like it. Okay. Things seem to be going fairly well. Just gonna dispel this curse once more. Gotta make sure we don't get agonied. We're holding the line. This is nice. Gotta hold it for 3 more minutes. See if we can do that. Alright, let's jump up here. Maybe get onto one of these cannons. See what we can do. And see actually how hard this cannon hits. Jump in! Fire! Like 30,000 per, that's pretty good. That's actually really good. 50,000. More damage. More damage. Just gonna shoot this Battleground Demolisher. And everyone else. Get shot! Yeah! The Gate of the Red Sun on the other side of the map is under attack. I am just, like, blowing these guys up. Yeah! Get shot, mage. For not too much. Maybe I should stop doing this. I need to go down and yeah. Okay, let's go down. Continue to defend, because that didn't feel like I was doing much. Good against the Battleground Demolishers, but other than that, alright, let's get more stuff out. It's all about the lava burst, guys. It's all about the lava burst. Except for that guy. I interrupted him. It's important that we interrupt him. And let's move over to Doc Waffles over here. Get more of these things out. We're gonna make him use his... Oh, there's a Demolisher on the way. Maybe we can stun it. I doubt we can stun it. Let's get back onto the cannon right now. That cannon's very good against the Battleground Demolisher. So let's just jump up here. Where are you? Battleground Demolisher. Oh, the Demolisher died already. Let's just stay up here and continue to fire. Because I feel somewhat safe up here. Ah, they're all out of my range. Damn. Alright, well, I have a good vantage point from up here. Until they all go out of my line of sight. Naturally. Another Battleground Demolisher. Quickly! Shoot it! Must shoot it! 2 minutes! Come on. Okay. More shooting the Demolisher. Shoot the Demolisher. Shoot the Demolisher. Guys, kill the Demolishers. Yeah. Slow the Demolisher. Root the Demolisher. Oh, the Relic Chamber. No. Shoot it, guys. Quickly. Quick, guys. Oh, okay, we're good. We're all fine. We can stop them from getting here. I'll move over here and root you, because you don't get to go near my Relic Chamber, mate. Yeah! I can't believe we're holding this line. This is the best thing. Yeah, the pain train is here, and it's coming right for you, Dorfy. Come here. Come here. I'm after you, Dorfy. I'm after you. How does it feel? Come here. No, no, no. Come here. Get him, Potters. Get him. Yes, the lava surge. Bam! The lava surge. Yeah! Just gotta keep him off, keep him off, keep him off. Oh, this guy's got a, shit, he's got deterrence on him. No, says I! No! Thunderstorm! Yes! And then I will shoot you! And then I will shoot you! And then I will capacitate on the rest of you! And then slow the rest of you! How does it feel? How does it feel to be stunned? And then rooted? Yes! Die! All of you will die! There's 40 more seconds, guys. Hold the line. I would like... I shouldn't even play. I should just literally just stand here and just, like, yell encouragement. Oh, he didn't get it off. Yeah! Get him, guys. We got this. We got this. Gonna lava burst that guy. Oh, oh God. Here comes... Oh, there's loads of them. 14 seconds. We just have to... Okay, now we... The gate's gonna be destroyed. We just have to keep them out of the chamber. Like, if they touch the artifact, we lose. We just have... Well... Okay, it's been breached. Just gotta hold the line. Hold the line. 2, 1. Yes! We did it! Yay! We actually defended it. Wow. Nice. Good. Okay, everyone going to green. Yes. I could be a commentator. I'm pretty proud of the fact that I could be a commentator. That was the best thing. That was amazing. We're probably still going to lose, but holy shit, what a match. The clutch defense is in it. Oh god, I admit I'm trembling a little bit. That was fun. See, moments like that, that's fun. Lokta for the horde! Yeah! Alright, so we have to grab demo charges and, like, lob them in. Maybe I'll just get in, go into a demolisher. That would be nice. All grain folked. I can't type. I'm too excited to type. Let's do this. Let's go for the demolisher. And then jump! Right into the demolisher. Go! It's gonna shoot you. I've been rooted. Ah! Keep firing! Fire over the cliff. Shoot the thing! Yes! Keep shooting the thing! Shoot the thing! Urgh. Shoot the thing! Urgh. Make sure we get out of range of this anti-personal carrier by going on this side. Just more shots, more shots! Keep firing at the thing! Fire at the thing! Yes, we're through! I'm probably gonna die there. Maybe I can get one shot off. Nope, looks like I can. Alright, so here are all the bad guys. There's a lot of them. I don't know where any of the things I use to destroy things are. I know nothing about this game! How do I play it? Alright, we'll get you up in the air, because I feel like it. And then stun you. And then we'll hex you, because I feel like it. Yeah, supporting the allies. That's what we do. That's what we do, guys. Actually, screw supporting our allies. Die! I mean, we're gonna kill him. Yeah. Got him. And then we'll kill you by ruining your day by thunderstorming you off the cliff. Alright. Got a lot of bad guys here. Gonna get my... as many of these things... Hi! Hope you're having a good day. Let's... Potters, you're under attack! Don't die on me, Potters! And we'll... Project, quickly! Nah, not quickly enough. Oh well, I think we stunned the other guy. I don't know how to play this, guys. I don't know where the bombs are. Someone tell me where the bombs are. I am the best raid leader. Alright, well, just sticking around here killing these guys isn't how we win this game, so let's back out. Let's find something to kill. Something to just... Hi. We'll just... I feel like flame-shocking you. Ow. Stop it, leave me alone! I don't want it! I don't want it. Okay. Oh, they're all after me! Run! 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 I'm actually helping here, because they're all going after me. They're not going for the, dudes. You know, the thing with the stuff, the way we win the game? They're not doing that. Which means that... Can I jump in the demolisher? Let me in! Let me in! Okay, bombs are in the graveyard, I've been told. I see them. Yeah, I see them. Fantastic. Okay. Let's grab a bomb. Okay, how do I use this? Places a massive CFOM charge, which will detonate after 10 seconds. Okay, I can do that. I was actually helpful there. I swear I was helpful. I was helpful because I pulled, like, three of them away from the fight. 3-for-1. Not too shabby, eh? Not too shabby indeed. Alright. Looks like there's still a big battle going on here. We don't want to get involved. Maybe we can save this guy. I will save you! I will save you, my friend! This is me saving you! Yes! I'm helpful! Now get... He's an elemental shaman as well! Yes! Elemental, represent! Apparently, that's the thing people say. I don't know. Let's just keep moving. Yeah. Okay. Tuskeh the Distractor, says Potters in chat. Yes! Absolutely. Ooh, that's a lot of bad guys! That's a lot of bad guys. Don't charge me, please. Just don't. You don't want to charge me. No one wants to attack me. Actually, right now, I am mind controlling all of you, and you don't want to attack me. What did I just say? What did I just say, guys? What did I just say? Place the bomb. Nope. Okay, that was a silly idea. That was a silly idea. Okay, Bubble Boy asks, so do you have a favorite fight in Hellfire Citadel? I do. For Elemental, Iskar. Iskar or Zul'Harak. I like Manoroth in general, though. To heal, definitely Gorfiend Mythic. Gorfiend Mythic to heal is fun as hell. It's just fun. I just enjoy it. Yeah, that's what I would suggest. I'd say that. Are we shooting the gate to the yellow moon? We are! Shoot the gate! Alright, I see bombs over here. I will grab the bomb. I'll grab the bomb and go for the door. We'll sneak through here. They'll never know what hit them, guys. There's so many of them, they're all here. Alright, well, we'll just thunderstorm them all away. Interesting, does this get interrupted? It gets interrupted by damage?! Oh, what?! What?! That's the worst thing! That is just, like, the worst thing! Who invented this?! Oh god! That's terrible! I did not know that was a thing that happened. That's okay, we still have 5 minutes. It's fine. And the gate of the Yellow Moon is nearly destroyed. Let's just grab a bomb and we'll just skirmish a bit. This is where they're probably gonna hold us for a while. The gate's down! Go! Go! Forwards, minions! I mean, allies! Thunderstorm all these guys away, just to, like... Oh no, I knocked them in the other direction because I'm terrible. Keep going! Keep going! Keep fighting! I've been stunned and I'm being eaten by crows. Okay. Place the bomb. I placed the bomb! Yes! I took a mint. If you know that reference, you're amazing. Yes! Get it! Go! Go, Daisar! Yes! We did it! We did it! Yes! Hashtag without the dying part. Yes. Exactly. Fantastic. I can't believe we did that. Yes! The clutch victory out of nowhere. Oh, that was fantastic. We won! Yay! That was great. Oh my god. Alright, let's have a look at what we can buy here. Is there even a point in buying any of this stuff? I mean... I don't think there is. I want to go for the conquest. Not that one. This one. I have just the thing. That was amazing. That was the best thing I've ever seen. Here we go. Okay, fantastic. I can't afford most of this. But... 7:30. Interesting. Okay, we'll grab this, I say. I'm probably doing it wrong. I don't care. That was great. That was good fun. GG. I don't know what happens if both sides get to the artifact. I think it's whoever got there sooner wins. So. Wow. That was quite the match. And that's actually going to conclude this stream. Because it's now 3 o'clock. It is time for tea time with Tuskeh to end. And for the weekend, at least for me, to begin. I'm actually going to release a video as soon as I'm done with this, and I'll be exporting this in two parts over the weekend as well. So, fantastic. That will be up on YouTube. And if you are watching this on YouTube and you want to see it live, it's every Monday and Friday, 1 to 3 p.m. EST. That's Eastern Standard Time. And I also stream our raids between Tuesday and Thursday from 8 p.m., 8:30 p.m. to 12:30 a.m. EST. That's all right. So, hopefully you enjoyed this. I had great fun. It was great to see you all. Thank you for listening to my depressing rants about what the hell's been going on recently. And you've been great. Absolutely fantastic. So, once again, thank you all very, very much for watching, and I wish you the best of luck in the World of Warcraft. Where's the button? Where is it? I'll find it.